the case itself can be quite costly. As you can see, for example, here you see you have some kind of plastic foam. Here it is a special design, specially molded design. So all those instruments here, they are specifically made for that musical instrument. And the cost of them can be sometimes as much or sometimes even exceed the cost of the product, which can present a problem. This year, I'm not sure if this happens with musical instrument cases. Gun cases. Probably also not, unless this is antique. Let's see. Antique gun case. So if you have antique gun case, they usually tend to be I don't see any. Well, this can be like let's say, see, this is a, we see some wooden cases, and those wooden cases can be made out of very expensive wood. And if so here you have some kind of drawing, right? So so those cases, because of their wood, because of their age, because of their probably ornamental value as well as collector's value, can be very expensive as well. And so the question is you have, you are importing, for example, a gun, and the gun costs 50% of the case. So the question is, should you classify this as a case and a gun as a gun, or should you classify this as a gun, right? That's the question. And general rule of thumb under the GRI 5A is that those cases, yes, we understand that they can be expensive instruments. We understand that for the expensive instruments, you can have expensive packaging, expensive cases. And because of that, we kind of understand that this is normal to have an expensive case for the expensive instrument. So we're going to allow these cases to be classified with such articles, meaning that you only classify this as, if it's a camera, with a case, you classify it as a camera. If it is a gun with a case, you classify it as a gun. with one exception. This rule, the last sentence states in 5A, however, applies to containers which does not apply to containers which give the whole its essential character. What can that be? The whole its essential character. So think about trying to find some good picture. So what I'm looking for is I'm looking where the container container would give, just a moment. Okay, so let's look at the sweets and ceramic bowl. Sweets, ceramic bowl. All right. So this is a picture that I was looking for. So you bring in a product. Let's say it can be wrapped in a plastic packaging, but the product itself is, you have a nicely made item. So here you have a Santa, here you have plastic ball, and it's topped off with candy, right? Candy topping off. The cost of the candy is maybe 5% of the cost of the container. Here, let's say, or even here, right? I think with this one we can agree that those sweets inside of the camel, I think if you import this camel with those sweets as such, how would you classify it? Will you classify it as sweets or as a ceramic ornament, ornamental article, or table, ceramic tableware? So what I'm trying to get to is that this would be an example where essential character, the packaging, provided that it is imported in that as that one thing. Here, essential character is taken over by the packaging. Here, I assume that the sweets is really just as a by the way. Well, the whole thing is about the camel. The reason I would buy this is because it's this ornamental camel gives a primary aesthetic value. So here, the container itself took over as far as essential character. So essential character is no longer presented by the candy, but it is presented by this ornamental ceramic article. And in this case, this is the GRI 5A last sentence was talking about when it was mentioning this rule does not, however, apply to containers which give the whole its essential character. So in the case with that camel, the essential, yes, it is candy. Yes, that ceramic camel container was a container, but the whole product was essentially characterized by that ceramic container bowl in the shape of the camel, not by the candy itself. All right. So any questions on 5A? So the whole point is, yes, container can be expensive. Container can be unique. And can cost a lot of money. But it is still be classifiable with that article unless you have this odd situation where you have some cheap stuff in a nicely designed container. In this case, container takes over as a social character. And when container takes over, you classify container as a separate line item. Not with the candy. Yes, you still classify the candy, but it is a separate, like the container is a separate line item in this case. And I think this camel image, kneeling camel sugar bowl, right? So it's a sugar. So you import sugar, right? With this ceramic tableware. Well, I really believe that this ceramic ceramic table, ceramic camel takes over as far as the essential character. So that would be an example of where container gives the essential character to the product. Next on the list is GRI 5B. All right, let's read. So GRI 5B pretty much says, look, yes, expensive items can have expensive packaging, but most of the items, they do not really require expensive stuff. Most of the items are consumer products. A lot of items are consumer products which have cheap packaging, disposable packaging. For example, I buy this water, I'll drink the water, and then I'll just, well, nowadays people recycle, right? So I get a 5 cents refund if I'm in Maine. I'm not sure if I get a refund in New York State, but probably I'll just throw this away. Yes, I know, it's not environmentally friendly, but problem is that if I try to recycle this, I have to stand in line where people with a bunch of beer bottles, they throw them away, and to really return this, it's just a bottleneck situation. So, but the point is not this. The point is whichever, whether recycle or just throwing it away, I plan to dispose of it, right? Once I empty this container, once I finish drinking water, what I do is I'm not going back to some kind of water source, right? Taking the cap off and pouring more water and start using this, right? No, most likely, it is just so cheap and it's just so common use, I'll just buy another one. And this type of material, the GRI 5B is designed to address. So let's take a look. Subject to the provisions of Rule 5A above, packing materials and packing containers entered with the goods shall be classified with the goods if they are of a kind normally used for packing with such goods. So that means if the water normally comes in the plastic jugs, which it does, you do not need to separately break out the plastic jug and classify it separately as plastic bottles, for example. You can just classify, kind of assume that this is normally normal container which is entered with water, and classify this whole product, if it is being imported, as water. You do not need to specifically break out the container, and the legal cover for not breaking it out is found here. See, because this good is of a kind normally used for packing such good. Is it normally used? Yes, it is. Okay, so it comes together. There is no separate tariff classification provision, and of course, with that, there is no separate duty attached. So, what's the problem here? Again, the rule like to those rules, they like to end things with a certain caveat, certain intricate point. And in this case, the intricate point is, however, see, those words, however, they just continually prop up. And you have a nice picture, right? Nice picture where it's normal for this container to be with water, so I'll classify it as water. But all of a sudden, you have this however, right? And this however brings a little bit of certainty, a little bit of gray area, gray shade, right, which is always uncomfortable, especially for those who sit in the customs broker exam, because we like certainty. However, this provision is not binding when such packing material or packing containers are clearly suitable for repetitive use. So, I have plastic which I will probably throw away, but I also purchased this water. Maybe I didn't purchase this water. I purchased water in this container. But I kind of like container because it's made out of glass. It is durable. The fact that it is not plastic gives me a little bit of comfort because of this phthalates here, right? We have those this agency, sister agency of customs, Consumer Product Safety Commission, which puts out those reports where plastics are not safe, they may cause cancer, etc., etc. Of course, under certain conditions. Congress listened to them. Then there's scientific community, whatever. I just feel more comfortable by drinking water out of a glass container. So what do I do? I'm buying this and drinking water. I'm refilling this glass container with water.